third episode of IFRM PR and COMCOM Next Gen series, where we are celebrating the win of the PR and comms professional who made it to the elite second list of IFRM PR and COMCOM 40 under 40. So today we have with us Mr. Anirudh Bhagwat, who is the CEO and co-founder at Ideos Air Consulting. So hello and welcome, Anirudh. How have you been?
Good. Hi, Nafisa. Thank you. And thank you for having me here.
Absolutely. It is a pleasure for us. And congratulations for being in the second list of 40 under 40. So my first question is obviously on how do you feel being a winner of this prestigious title?
I think obviously it feels great. From the time that we've recently had over the last 8 months, it's definitely a great time to be on a list and provide some amount of motivation to keep going and kind of going towards the passion. But what I would say is that, you know, there's a certain vision that we've all probably built for ourselves professionally. And these lists and this one particularly kind of just gives a small indication that you're on the right track. Obviously, there's a long way to go, but maybe it gives an indication that you're on the right track. So it is good to be on it and also being connected with the other 39 people, right? These are all stalwarts in the industry, and it's good to have a platform or a reason to connect and kind of learn from more people.
Awesome. And we really hope that we continue this winning streak and the celebrations throughout the new year. So, Anirudh, we have seen that the industry has gone through a lot of changes, and more so in the past 10 months. So, what kind of sentimental changes have you observed in this industry? And maybe we can talk about what are the broad trends that you have observed according to you.
So, I think one of the bigger trends that I would see, Nafisa, is that even, and this is not necessarily only because of the pandemic, even before the pandemic, we saw communications as a domain or as a practice start taking a much more business-centric role in many enterprises, right? Enterprises around the world start understanding that communication is actually by far maybe one of the most important things to run, not just finance, not just marketing, not just sales, but communications as an art. And because of which we saw the movement of communication professionals moving to business roles as well within organizations. I think that because of the pandemic, I think it's further accelerated that trend where organizations are understanding that communication is now really one of the most important things because of the fact that every single thing that's said by an organization today, because it's appearing everywhere on a two-way engagement platform like a Twitter or an IG or whatever, where consumers can immediately reply, have an opinion, right, and influence others to also have an opinion. In those type of situations, the construct of message and the depth of how we want to communicate becomes so important for every brand. And I think that's been probably the biggest accelerant in this time for, as I've seen as a trend. And obviously, just like any other industry, embracing technology, picking up digital platforms to collaborate. I mean, these are things that everyone would do. I don't think that's specific to PR or communication as a practice. But I would say that the biggest thing is that adaptability or innovation of how are we going to make things work. And I think another trend is also the fact that within consultancies, because of the fact that today, or rather recently, we've not been able to actually physically meet customers or physically meet influencers, etc. How do you create those platforms of engagement? How do you create a media launch in a fully digital environment, right? We are seeing a lot of industry conferences like yours also happening on a digital front, and there's a lot of innovation that goes in that, right? So I think those are the broad trends that I would see.
Okay, and you talked about adaptability, flexibility, evolution, and innovation. So I would like to ask you and have some insights on the kind of skills that are required right now to prevail, do better in the market that has really shaped up.
So I think one of the biggest things is, I would say that it has nothing to do with core skills for me, because I think pre-pandemic and post-pandemic, the core skills of our domain are things that remain constant, right? I mean, at least I can speak from a PR agency perspective and probably any type of agency in marketing. One of the biggest advantages is that we get to be exposed to so many industries at the same time, which also means that our learning is continuous. It's part of our job, really. You know, it's something that we have to do across industries to do our job well. So those type of core skills of getting better at the industries that you handle and getting deeper into, you know, we had technology coming in, how do you look at ML, AI, and VR, and a lot of data curation. All of these things have been spoken about even pre-pandemic, like I said, maybe accelerated in this particular time. But I think that the biggest skills that are on demand in the industry today are non-core skills, where we are actually looking at the maturity of the professional. We are looking at the adaptability of the professional, knowing that we are in uncertain times, that will this person be able to adapt to different situations, not only on from a delivery perspective, but even from a work perspective, because things are changing on a rapid basis, right? And the other aspect would also be how mentally aware or in control this person is. And I think that's gotten more and more important, right? And as organizations also, we are doing a lot, or we're trying to do as much as possible for our own teams in terms of, you know, well-being and things like that, because I think it's very, very important because it directly affects work. You know, there's an argument that it is more of a personal thing. You know, your mental state of mind is a personal thing. For all those who are completely business oriented, my answer to that would be that great wellness amongst your team, having a good emotional quotient as an aggregate within your team, is directly proportionate to how good and how well you will do in business. Because at the end of the day, if we are all happy doing what we want to do, we just do better of it, right? So even from a business perspective, it makes sense. And I think those are the types of skills of adaptability, of having a high emotional quotient, having a high maturity. I think these are the types of skills that are most in demand, apart from a lot of the technology skill sets and communication and content skill set that the industry has been adding for the past few years now.
Okay. And, you know, we have all been working from home, and this is also an example of how we are working from our homes, doing everything virtually. So if I ask you, what has been your experience of working from home and with your team? Maybe you must have, you know, came to know a lot of new stuff about your team, and what are the, you know, new experiences that you had during these 8 to 9 months?
Sure. Well, firstly, let me make a statement that I'm sitting in office right now because we have started coming to office.
Okay.
And it feels good. I tell you, work from home has been a really incredible learning experience, not only for the organization, all of our leadership as well, and to myself, right? Because I think that you know, self-growth was a lot that happened during this time, because you started being more at embracing digital technology, embracing collaboration, being okay with uncertainty, being okay with work-life balance as it presents itself, because everything had changed, right? So I think that was the biggest aspect that I would kind of look at. But when it comes to where we are kind of going, or the skills or the qualities that we need, I think it's very important to look at that emotional portion. Sorry, I forgot your question in between.
I was asking a rather lighter question, like what are the new experiences you had with your team? Maybe you came up with some, you know, new things about them, right?
So the biggest, experience I must tell you is that our anniversary was actually right during the lockdown. Right. And usually we always have a habit of going on offsites together and kind of connecting. And we did this entire, again, our first time of the team really trying to put together a digital type of celebration. And we called in a lot of alumni from Ideosphere in the past, people who worked with us and had a great turnout. It was an excellent time, because at that point of time, you obviously adapt to the fact that this is the best we can do in terms of for yourself also in connecting with people. And I think that is something that was an experience of mine, which kind of worked out really well. But you also asked about my impression of work from home. Honestly, I think that in the given circumstances, it, you know, when it's needed, it's needed. And we always will put you know, the safety of all of us as highest priority. But in the situation that it is not needed, I would be a person that would rather be in office. I think that collaboration, I think that seeing people on a regular basis, the water cooler talks and all of those things that they call it, are very, very important to me as a professional. I think they add a lot of value to a business. And given the circumstances are safe and it's possible, I would definitely look at a hybrid now between work from home and work at office. I think it should always be a hybrid. I'm not sure if work from home permanently would be something I would be comfortable with in that sense because of current experience.
So I think you basically kind of somewhere answered my next question that I was about to ask. Like, is the industry ready to go fully virtual in the times to come, or are we technologically adept to go to that next step now?
I think absolutely we are. I mean, I would, and I'm speaking as an industry, look at the type of events that we've been able to run without much delay. Look at the type of digital collaborations that we've been able to do. Even you know, platforms and communities that, you know, for a media platform like yours who's trying to build, even you guys have done that, right? I've seen a lot of consultancies have done media launches and you know, press meets, and work has been as usual. So I think it really shows to the resilience of the team. I don't think it was very hard for all of us to pick up. And I think that at times when we are in situations where we have to figure out as a community and as professionals, I think we've always been very innovative to, you know, keep on moving ahead and figuring out what could be solutions. So I think in that sense, we've been as an industry, I think we've shown a lot of resilience during this time, because while there have been challenges, it seems like we've not missed a beat and we've only gotten better post-pandemic.
I think resilience is the right word. Everybody has shown that kind of resilience and adaptability. So Anirudh, moving on, if I ask about your firm, Ideosphere, and how has Ideosphere utilized or used the challenges into an opportunity in the past 8 to 9 months?
So I think one of the biggest challenges was that we were work from home, right? And I think that that we learned a lot about what is it to connect with the team, what is it, how do we maintain the same culture of an organization in a digital, remote, omnipresent type of level. We're still learning it, by the way. But I think that was a huge learning of the lockdown. The other thing is also it gave us time to introspect. You know, obviously, when the lockdown started, some of our customers, you know, wanted to renegotiate. Some of our customers paused their contracts. A couple of them left also. So speaking as business, yes, it was a difficult time. But at the same time, it was important, and it gave us time to actually introspect a bit, have much more deeper conversations about the business with leadership and with the team in terms of where are we going, what should be our vision. How do we get prepared post-pandemic? I mean, you look at it as a time for preparation. You know, I do believe that a lot of things happen for a reason in that sense. And in that sense, it is a learning for all of us. So a lot, like I said, a lot of the learning that we've had because of the pandemic, we've just sped up our whole industry-wide digital transformation like times 10, right? It just happened immediately. It should have happened a long time ago, needed something like this to happen to actually get us there, but we are there. And even post-pandemic, when things go back, we'll still continue to have these skills. So we'll be much more agile as an industry. We'll be much more flexible. From an Ideosphere perspective, we realize that measurability is going to be important in the future. Evidence-based measurability, where we can actually show not only the impact of our work to brand, but also to business, aligning to what I said initially in your question. And because of that, we are able to develop some outcome-based models for business, look at how we want to structure our business, where we went into more of an understanding of what customers want. We also launched our white paper sometime during the lockdown. So it's been a lot of learning, Nafisa, so mainly introspection, being agile and flexible, and also adaptability of the team. Like I can tell you without a doubt, everybody on my team did better than me at adaptability during the lockdown. It was the most difficult for me. And I really hats off to them, because I used to look at saying everything is continuing as business, you know, as business as usual to the most extent. Probably I took a couple more days to get on the bus, but it was that way a great learning and a great self-discovery of our own selves, all of us.
And yes, and absolutely, we have to, you know, keep the ball rolling to sail through these difficult times. And we have actually, everyone has come out as winners, right? And so, Anirudh, you have been an entrepreneur, if I am not wrong, right? So,
yes.
And there are many people who aspire to be one. So, what are the qualities or maybe the important skill sets required to, you know, come out or become a successful entrepreneur in this industry, according to you?
So I think that it's very easy to start a business in our industry, mainly because of the fact that you need only a laptop and internet connection to start a business, right? So in that sense, there are very less barriers for anyone to start. And probably after almost 9 years of Ideosphere, one of the things that we have started to realize as entrepreneurs is that a business must have a very, very clear purpose and a differentiation of why they want to do it. If you're going to go into an industry of just having another consultancy or another agency, and I understand that the differences are wafer thin, but you must have some of them. Because my thinking is that you're taking a risk as an entrepreneur to start a business. You're doing it to create value for yourself and others. And when you're doing that, why would you leave and do exactly what's there in the industry? Because that increases your risk of failure. Because there's just one more. If the only way you can succeed is to have something clearly differentiated, number one. So I think one must understand that why and what is the intent of why am I going to start something. The second aspect is that we must know the business of our craft, not the craft itself. I've seen so many remarkable communication professionals at times struggle in running a business because they may understand the craft, but they don't know the business of the craft. And I think one of the things that young professionals who wish to be entrepreneurs shall do is that during the course of their work, try and observe and understand the business, understand how margins work, try to think about how does this whole ship float at the agency that you're in. Because those type of learnings and that type of observation will definitely help. So that would be the second thing. And the third is how strong are you emotionally? Because entrepreneurship is all about being able to handle good and bad well. It's being able to manage stress extremely well. There's going to be uncertain times. I mean, you essentially step into a world of uncertainty from the day you start. And you need to be extremely strong and mentally aware and mentally in control to do that. And a lot of these things, honestly, I personally, and I can vouch on our entire leadership and my co-founder Mina, that we've learned is that it's something we are learning now. I wish that somebody would have taught us that before. But I think the business of what you're in, your attitude and your self-control or your ability to handle stress is very, very important to being a great entrepreneur, along with the fact that your business must be differentiated. There must be a reason for why you want to start something.
I think your voice would be really helpful for people who are, on this way of being an entrepreneur. So Anirudh, as we know that we are in the last month of 2020 and we are going towards 2021. So what, according to you, would be the key innovations that might reshape the PR and popcom industry in the times to come? Maybe we can talk about two or three innovations according to you.
I think... I'll tell you, I don't know, I should call that more of my forecast of what I think that we should be doing as an industry. I think that overall, because of the fact that hybrid work environments will continue, I think digitization of our entire delivery process, and this is not only for PR, but any type of any type of agency as such in marketing, but I think digitization of that, automation of a lot of manual workflows and redundancies in our own business, which we do on a daily basis that continue to do the same thing. And at times it gets monotonous, but we don't take the effort of finding a better way to do it. And I think we are starting to do that and having those engines which will allow us to define process and systems in a consistent and automated form where you're actually obviously in a way digitally transforming yourself to do that, where the communication professionals sit on top of the system as thinkers, as problem solvers, as content creators, and let the system do the redundancy of manual workflows and try to ensure that you're spending time on quality. I think this is where probably as an industry we will go, because we need to get we need to get much more efficient and consistent in our delivery. What happens across multiple consultancies is that different teams often deliver at different quality levels, and it could be on different, and I think this is a challenge all consultancies face. Somewhere digitizing at least the bottom functional layer could help in that. It's not going to be an answer. It could help in that. And the second thing that I see in 2021 is I see more, and it's already happened, but I see more consumer behavior or consumer psychologists coming into our fraternity or those skill sets being required in our fraternity. I think understanding of the human mind is very important for us as PR professionals, because at the end of the day, there are so many mediums, so many messages one can deliver. How do we know and how do we get into the minds of our audience of who we are talking to? I think a lot has to do with consumer psychology. And there are, it's already, there are professionals with that background in the industry, but I think you're going to see many more of that. So one on a technology side, one on a skill set side, I think those are going to be the major trends, Nafisa, in my opinion.
Absolutely. I think communication has taken the center stage now, and more so it will be amplified in the years to come. So Anirudh, let's move to my, maybe the second last part of this interview. What are your future plans?
So like I said, we took that time to kind of get feedback from customers with the pandemic time to kind of introspect in what we want to do. We've kind of realized the need for having a single window service for customers, right? Where they would want a lot of their communications to be done from one particular team or rather led by one team. And what I mean by communication is not only media relations, but it could be content, it could be sales content, it could be what the leadership is saying, internal communication, there's multiple facets. And for that, you require obviously a division of insights where you're continuously getting insights from the market or your stakeholders. You require content to be created and all sorts of content. And you require the go-to-market or amplification, which is how do I go out, whether it's social media or PR. And we've actually built these three into SBUs within our business. We have project managers which manage the brand. And we are able to give that single window. So over time, we've also been able to build a strong ecosystem, which is a platform that we've built. We have about 75 partners who we've all worked with and ranked and rated. And these are across design, content, etc. So we are able to measure that quality and give a single window. I think the future plans for Ideosphere also lie in how are we going to be able to technologically look at our value chain and figure out where can we really, in a way, transform ourselves. What can we do better? How can we become more efficient? Something we call internally about the 6 P's, which I won't get into, but things like productivity, performance, and those type of things that we want to kind of look at. And how do we be? How are we able to build platforms that can provide a measurable answer to that? Apart from which, one of the other things is also to figure out how can we use our insights, which is a key differentiator and something very close to each of our hearts at Ideosphere. How do we use that to create a larger impact in the community? How can we look at insights as the larger play, because we've been doing it for many years and we started also evolving into understanding and going deeper into that. So I look forward to how we can use that better as well. So these are the two things, one from a technology transformation perspective and the other from a product perspective of what more we can do with the type of really good work we've been doing on insights.
And if I ask on your personal front and not Ideosphere, if you talked about Ideosphere, what are your personal goals for the future?
So my personal goals are, one is to be a little bit and continue to learn to be more patient in life and more calm and collected in this environment. I think one of the things that this has taught us is patience. And that's one of the things that I see for myself going forward. The other is also trying to understand that when, as a leader, trying to get better at transparency, at fairness, at understanding what is the right thing to do, not running away from, in a way, what one may call a sticky situation or something that's difficult to do it and you face it head on and you find the right solution, which is the right way to go about a business. And those type of things is a learning for me as just a leader. I think that continues to happen. The third thing is to spend more time with my family and try to ensure that I continue. And it's something where probably what the pandemic has also taught us that you should enjoy work, you should enjoy fun, you should enjoy family. And it really is just being about, it's about your mind being where you are at that point of time physically. So if you are at home, be at home. If you're at work, be at work. And as long as we do that, I think we tend to be happier. And I want to ensure I do that. So a lot of, Nafisa, a lot of changes. I don't know what I see for myself. If I do this well, then it will definitely be a great year.
Awesome, Anirudh. I think this was an insightful talk. I would just like to finish this interaction on an exciting and fun note. And let's play some rapid fire, right? So I will just say some terms and you have to speak the first word that comes in your mind, right?
Okay.
So shall we start? So when I say digital, what do you mean?
Transformation.
Social media?
Conversation.
Influencer marketing?
PR.
Technology?
Permanence, just there now, part of our life.
40 under 40 list.
Great milestone.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Anirudh. This was really an insightful and exciting talk. Thank you so much for being here. And once again, congratulations.
Thanks, Nafisa. Thanks to the Exchange for Media team for having me. It was great for me as well.